We see how far you'll go for your mates.
Actually, before we start, there's something I want to say.
Okay.
Well, when we started doing this show, I didn't know, as well as getting a new job, I'd also be making a new friend.
Right.
But that's just how things turned out, and sometimes we don't say this enough, so I just want to say, thanks for being my friend. Not you, you loser.
Three tasks.
Three treats.
One's down to luck.
The rest is their choice.
Will they play fair?
Will they play dirty?
Will they still be
the best of friends?
We are the Gangsters! That means we're the best of friends you've ever seen!
For sure.
Matt's really kind and he's considerate and he likes to look after people a lot.
Tyler, he likes having funny hairstyles. He likes designing his hair. His hair's always designed, when I see him, he's always got different designs on his hair.
Andre's the biggest of the group. He likes the app bag.
Dominic, he always makes you laugh, like in class, by just saying funny stuff.
Me and Samson get along really well. So if I said a joke, he'd start laughing at it and vice versa.
I didn't mean to. It was an accident. Sorry, lads.
Typical, isn't it, boys? Anyway, Andre, tell us, how did you all become best mates?
We went to the same school, like, known each other since when we was, like, young ages, so we've just got on together.
Oh, great stuff.
So, Mark, what sort of stuff do you do when you're kind of out of school, like, hanging out together?
Like, go to skate parks, we go to ball and go somewhere, we just have fun together all the time.
Now, Samson, what wouldn't you do for your best mates?
I'd do everything because they're my friends and we want to pass all the tasks and hopefully we will.
So, Tyler, everyone comes onto the show, they think they're best of friends, but what makes you guys different from everyone else?
Well, we chill out together, just mess around, play together, and we're just best of friends.
Should we form the first circle of friendship?
I think we should. After three. One, two, three.
We are the Gangsters, all set beaters, nothing you'll ever gonna defeat us!
Big up, big up, big up. I'd probably better leave it to them, mate. It's a lot cooler than I did.
Is it, Leah? All right then, lads. The fun is about to start because you've got three rounds to get through before you get yourself that ultimate mystery treat.
So to find out who's going on the first task and who's going on the first treat, we're going to leave it down to luck and bring in the unlucky dip.
Now, in this bag there are five sweets. Three of them will turn your tongues blue. And if that happens, you're going to get yourself the first task. You're looking nervous.
However, though, there are two sweets in there that will leave you with a clear tongue. If you get the clear tongue, you'll be doing the first treat of the day, which is going to be good fun, all right?
Yeah.
So should we find out who's doing what? Shut your eyes for us.
So which three of our five mates from Leeds will be going on the first task? All right, lads, just one more thing, and that's...
You suck!
Will it be Mark, Dominic, Tyler, Samson, or Andre?
One, two, three!
Tongues out! It's Dominic, Samson, and Andre. All right, lad, take a look at each other.
So this lot know what they're doing, but what about us?
Let's bring in the unlucky dip.
That's so funny.
Thank you very much. All right, my turn first.
OK, go for it. All right then, lads, we've got our sweets. What do we do now?
You suck!
It's time to get very, very wet. You have to gather as much water as you can from a paddling pool and transfer it into our best of friends container. Sounds easy enough. The aim is to pass the level indicated. Sounds easy, but not when you're wearing a special suit made entirely of sponges. Get squeezing.
All right then, Mark, Tyler, you ready to find out what your first treat is?
Yeah!
All right then, we just need to make our way to this aeroplane here. All the information's here, follow me. We are going to be flying remote control planes. This treat is all about taking to the air. You get to fly a top of the range remote control aeroplanes with the expert help of our best of friends pilots. Up, up and away. You haven't flown much before, have you?
When I flew my plane the first time, I wasn't really good. I crashed it all the time.
Crash.
All right, Samson, your first task is about to start. What you need to do is climb into that paddling pool, wearing your sponge suit, soak up as much water as you can, run over there, squeeze it out into the bucket, do that as many times as you can, and remember, as a team, you are working your way up to the 3-litre mark. So, are you ready to get wet?
Yeah.
All right, your time starts. In he goes, go roll around, get as much water as you can, and there's a goal. Come on. Don't slip over, we've got a long journey into this. Don't splash me. Let's squeeze you out as much as we can. We did not a bad job there. Oh! Off you go, go!
Not bad. The most tricky thing was to do was when you've been in the paddling pool and rolling around, it was really, really hard to get up out of the pool. That was the hardest part.
Squeeze, squeeze, I'll squeeze you back. All right, you've got 3 seconds left. Let's get as much out as you can. Why stop the clock?
Mark was the best at flying the planes. It was really good. He landed it really good.
Off he goes. Come on, have you got enough water in there?
The funniest thing about the task was when we had to run across because it was quite hard, because all the water was stuck to us and it was getting quite heavy, and a lot of people was running funny, like ducks and everything, so that was quite funny.
Just get as much water as you can. There you go.
Got some pipe.
Absolutely just terrible. He almost broke the thing in three. His landing was crashed, should I say. Was just that bad. There's no words to express how bad it was.
Should it be in two halves?
Here he goes!
When I put the suit on, I found it quite hard because it was quite heavy. But when I got in the pool, it was even heavier, but after about a minute and a half, I got used to it. So that was quite fun.
3, 2, that's it, your time's up. Let's find out if you passed your task. Samson, bring over your bucket. Let's see where we get up to. Will we get up? Good job, son!
Yeah!
There you go, well done for that. Bet your mum will be proud.
Remy, come for celebration, run, come on!
Everybody in the group, well, I'm sure if they try the hardest, they can do the same as everybody else. And I hope that they all try their best, because I know that all of us who have done the first task have tried our best. So I hope they're going to try their best as well.
Here we are again then, but what have you done with Rani? Where is she?
I don't know.
Hang on, I'm here.
What are
sorry.
You doing? You're late. And why have you changed clothes?
Let's just say I had a little bit of an accident. Nothing to do with the task, of course.
So, Andre, what did you get up to for your task?
Well, first of all, we had to get in a suit with loads of sponges all over our body, and then we had to dive into a paddling pool and roll over and get the sponges wet, and then we had to run to a bucket and squeeze out all the water out of the sponges, and then we had to do that in 2 minutes and fill up this big tube.
We got to fly planes, remote control planes, and also we got our own planes off the man, our own planes to keep.
What we need to know, you guys were doing the task first of all.
Yeah.
It's very important that you passed the task, but did you?
No.
Well,
no.
Yeah, we did.
You're saying that? I don't know who to believe. Is it a no? Is it a yes? Stop playing games.
We did. We had to collect 3 litres, but we got about what?
Yeah, we got about 15.
Yeah, 15 litres. Samson did it with just his bucket.
Two of you could either volunteer to do the next task, or you can use the unlucky dip to select two people.
Get in there and have a chat.
So I think we should volunteer two people because
you can't volunteer two people.
Well, two people should volunteer because it's not fair.
You've been on a treat and you've got your own plane to
keep. So tomorrow's always another day. So if we do it fair, it'll work out.
You're just being unfair.
As everybody had the turn, because if somebody didn't do the task, that is not fair.
Well, I'm not backing down. That's all I've got to say.
I'll volunteer. Thank you, Mark. I vote for volunteering.
You can't always do the unlucky dip just with one blue sweet in it.
Yeah, that's what I think.
If you can get one to volunteer.
Yeah, but
it,
then
might,
suppose,
it might land on me.
Yeah, but suppose it doesn't then? Then it's not fair on doing it.
Don't matter then.
If you had the tree, like me and Mark did, you lot wouldn't volunteer.
I would.
I honestly would say that I'd volunteer, because then I'd be on the fair, wouldn't it?
What do you think, Tyler?
You know what? If these are going to beef like that, all right, I'll do it.
Thank you.
One, two, three.
We are the dancers!
I think Tyler wanted to do the treat, so he was thinking he's getting a greedy.
Okay, well, we do need to get a decision from you either way, whether it's going to be the unlucky dip or two of you are going to volunteer.
I wonder what's going to be.
We're going to do the task tomorrow.
Yeah, but we agreed that we'll take it in turns and be fair. Yeah. That's what we said. Didn't we before we came
but
in here?
Tyler didn't want to do the task because he thought that we was being selfish, but he didn't realise that about what he was doing himself.
Put your hands up if you'd like to volunteer for the second task. It's Mark and Tyler.
Very reluctant Tyler there, but he's gonna...
I didn't want to do the task for this round, but my friends made me. Samson, he didn't look too happy, so I decided to do the task.
Abs, shall we pick a sweet?
I think we should. It's the presenter's unlucky dip. Here we go. What's the face? Okay. All right then, lads. We've got our sweets. What do we do?
You suck!
All right, here we are then at St. James's Hospital. You might recognise it. We're here to do your second task, which, as you know, is going to be a little bit tougher. So should we find out what it is?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. It's called plaster cast. Listen carefully to the instructions during this task, as you'll be shown how to apply a plaster cast to a person's leg. You then have to work together to plaster up Abs's leg. Great. Making sure it's good enough to mend properly. Our expert nurse will decide if you pass or if you fail. I'm a bit ticklish, so be careful.
So what we do is like a figure of eight. And then as you're coming up the leg, you want to cover it 50%, so overlap it halfway along the bandage. Next becomes plaster of Paris.
Are you taking all this in, fellas?
This is a brilliant way to travel. Via a water cabling system, you get to try out the exhilarating sport of kneeboarding. It's wet and wild.
Kneeboarding was really great because I thought that would have been the main treat, but it wasn't, it was only the second. So I don't know what's going to be in store for the last treat, but I'm really looking forward to it and I enjoyed kneeboarding so much.
Tyler, Mark, you can begin your task.
I think it's fair I'm doing the task because I've already done the tree.
That should stay there.
You say so?
We weren't doing that well at the beginning, but we went on
then it started being funny because Abs couldn't feel his leg because it was all hardening up and he couldn't move it. Only he could only move his toes.
So are you happy with that, fellas? Does it look good?
Yeah.
I'm quite impressed. Get your hands washed off and we'll get it judged. So, Angie, how did they do?
Well, they didn't do too badly. They started off really well with a stockinette. You moulded it really well. It's a little bit long at the end. I don't know how he's going to get about bending his knee. But all in all, I think you did really well. So I think we can pass you.
Yes!
Hi, Ronnie.
Hi, Abs.
How you doing?
All right, darling, we've got some people here who want to speak to your people.
All right, I'll pass you over to Mark.
What did you do?
We went kneeboarding, slack jet skiing.
We had to plaster Abs's leg up.
Was it funny?
Yeah. He couldn't move in it, he had to go in a wheelchair.
Well, I spent the afternoon in accident and emergency, A&E, as they like to call it, and look, that's my leg.
Oh,
well, it's not really my
smells.
Leg. Yeah, I'm going to whip it out on the boys tomorrow and go, ooh, smell it, smell it. It's all
Sticks,
cheesy.
Get it away from me.
It's pretty gross.
It is a bit gross, but the task tomorrow, it's going to get worse.
I'm sure it is, yeah. No ideas what it's going to be, though.
Cheeky, cheeky.
Did you hear that?
What?
Cheeky, cheeky.
That?
Yeah.
No. Don't believe this. It's usually me that takes all the time in the bathroom, but today, it's him.
Oh, I knew I should have my legs waxed before I started filming. Oh, gonna be late. Take a look at that.
Oh,
it's a bit cheesy because it's had my feet in it, but that's a plaster cast. So why don't you tell me a bit more about what we did, Mark?
Well, yesterday, our task was we had to plaster Ab's leg up, and this is what we did.
Did you pass it? Did you fail?
We passed.
Yay! Well done, guys. It's very good news because that means final task, only one of you needs to do it, and remember, it's the hardest one.
So here are your options. One person can volunteer to do the final task by themselves, or you can use the unlucky dip between five of you to select that one person.
Or, final task, how would you like to all do it together? Stick together as mates and hopefully you'll pass it. But do remember, if one of you fails, you all fail and no one gets to go on the final truth.
I'll move this out of your way because it's a bit of a distraction. I'll pop it back under the table. There we go. And have a chat about what you guys want to do.
I think one of us should because if it's five of us, it's going to be a lot harder, isn't it? So because if you think about it.
If four people have passed and one fails, we'll be mad at the one person who fails. If one person fails, they can be mad at herself, not at
the because if all five of us did it and then one let us down, that means...
No, it's not really fair.
We're volunteering or what? Who's volunteering?
Me.
You want to volunteer?
Are you sure?
Okay.
You don't have to if you don't want to.
I volunteer.
Are you sure?
Do you want to?
No, I don't think you do want to. I think you're just saying it.
I don't want to do it.
Yeah, but what if you lose? That's the thing.
Don't argue with me. I'm doing it.
Sure, Ma?
Yeah.
It's your decision, you know.
Yeah,
not,
it is.
Bad,
I'm doing it.
I think that we all should do it together anyway.
Why do you think that?
Because we're a team and we're friends.
What if we fail?
We fail?
Well, if we lose, that means at least we've all had a go.
Why do you want to do it so much on your own, Mark?
Because these are my best of friends. I'd do anything for my best of friends.
But isn't being best of friends working as a team as well?
Yeah.
Best of friends.
No, best friends is doing things for your friends, not your friends.
But I think they're looking out for you as well, in that what they're saying is if you fail the final task, they want you to be on that final treat, and what they'd rather have is that you all fail together and still be really good mates.
They miss you.
Yeah, all just get stuck into that final treat together.
I won't be really happy doing the treat knowing
exactly.
That Mark...
Exactly.
I won't have fun.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't enjoy myself.
One, two, three.
We are the gangsters from St. Peter's. Nothing is ever gonna defeat us.
Final decision, please, for your final task.
We're all going to do it together.
We're all going to do it together.
It's time for the presenter's unlucky dip. It's one all. You've had one tussle. Up your face again.
Thank you.
Got a sweet? You got your sweet?
Yeah.
What do we do now?
You suck!
Thank you.
Could ask you to do would be to dance with the cheeky girls.
When I was getting picked for the best of friends, I put on my form that I didn't want to be to dance with the cheeky girls. And they took it into consideration and they made us dance with the cheeky girls.
When I found out about what my task was, I felt shocked. I felt so I was gonna be embarrassed. I don't like dancing with cheeky girls, I don't like dancing at all.
If those gangsters from St. Peter's can complete their cheeky task, then they've got this monster treat to look forward to. Fire it up, let's go, let's do this thing.
But now what you have to do is to learn the Hey Boy dance routine. You'll have to dance well enough to impress us. Otherwise, you don't pass the task. So the first movement is like this. With your hands up in the air, you go one and two. And you have to move your shoulders.
About the cheeky girls, I don't really listen to their music. Sometimes I just watch the videos and dance to it, but now and again, but I don't really listen to the music, but they're nice people.
Left, one, and you just go
and then
down.
Pull it out.
I don't really have a favourite because they both look the same, act the same and talk the same, so they both like the same.
Now we can go to the next step.
I was shocked at first because when I saw cheeky girls, do all their moves, I thought, oh no, we'll never be able to do this.
5, 6, 7, 8. What is this? I can't believe. Let's stay calm. Don't get stressed.
I think I forgot the first bit.
Okay guys, it's time for the final performance. And don't forget, we are looking on all those dance moves. Cue the music! Come on! Come on! Warm up! I think that all of them were quite good dancers, I have to say. But the best one, who was like more active and with a lot more energy, was Dom. All the boys were really good dancers. We were really, really impressed. I think that Tyler, he was a bit slow in learning the dance moves, but Dominic and Samson, they were really good. Good dancers, and you did work really, really hard, and we did judge very hard. But I have to say that you did pass the test.
Yeah!
told me to meet him here.
But I haven't got a clue where he is.
Hiya! You're right!
Yeah!
Look, what? You'll never guess what we're doing.
It will be broken because we've all worked together and we've all worked as a team, even though Tyler hasn't put all his effort into it and some others have. So we will stay best of friends.
The final cheat was the best because even though we had to dance with the cheeky girls, we still passed.
The worst moment in Best of Friends was when I had to dance with the cheeky girls. I did not want to dance with them because I don't really like them.
Nobody in the team has let anybody down. We've all helped each other and we're all at the same strength.
When I said this morning that I'd do anything for my friends, I really meant it because my friends are the best people I know, and I'd do anything for them.
I think you'll agree it's been a monstrously cheeky show here today.
We'll see you next time and we're going to put more friendships to the test. See ya.
Bye.
Bye. Yeah!
That's my car!